Keith Mills with sports with some very special guests.
Absolutely. We have Kristen Brooks of the National Kidney Foundation and my daughter, Allie, who's also working at the Kidney Foundation now. And welcome, ladies.
Yes. Thank you.
Kristen, you've been dealing with my daughter for the last couple weeks now. Oh, thank you.
Oh, I see the resemblance.
Takes it as her mother. What's that?
I see the resemblance.
No, you don't.
Yes, I do.
You're both white.
Thank God. Thank God she doesn't have an ass crack forehead. I just say that.
I do a little bit.
No, you're.
This is as she'll tell you. My mother had one. My grandmother had one. So this is hereditary.
That thing in the middle of your forehead goes all the way down through the years.
Yeah. Generations of Mills have had the trench.
My brother has one too. So.
Oh, so Mills Jr. What is it like having Keith as your dad? Just a guy you can't set 10 feet outside before someone comes running up. They used to know him from Lansdowne.
You know, it used to be like that, walking in the mall. And you know, my brother and I would just keep walking at some point. But, you know, as he's gotten older, we've been pretty used to it.
Yeah, it's okay. It's okay.
When that happens,
they just keep going, man.
Is he just dad or is there another layer to that?
He's dad. I mean, he's he's dad.
Yeah, but he's like Spiegel walked into the studio and he made a joke. It wasn't really a joke. It's true. He looks at Spiegel. He goes, "Living legend, Josh Spiegel. What did I call you at the parade?"
You did. But
I hopped up on stage and said, "Give it up for Keith Mills. The man is a legend."
I'm not so sure that applies.
Of course it does.
Definitely applies.
Why?
Because.
Why? Because you had a couple of missteps?
I come from the Vince Bagley school of being humble. It's not about you. It's about the people that
I'm saying it and everyone else is saying it.
I appreciate that.
You don't have to say it, but we can.
I never looked at myself that way. I looked at myself as just coming to work every day, like, you know.
And that's what makes you part of a legend.
I appreciate
that. Yeah. But you're beloved around here. You're sort of like everyone's dad. You got that great nickname.
Yeah, Sack Daddy.
Yeah.
Sack Daddy.
I mean, we love you. You ask the hard questions, too.
You have a big butt chat. Give us. What was it?
You have a big butt chat. I don't want to tell you this is going to happen, but this is going to happen.
Oh, yeah. Oh,
they got a whole bunch of stuff stored up.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Is it hard?
They got pounded. A big old pounder. He's pounding the meat.
Those guys sucking it up and doing that. I'm telling you, come on out here,
big boy.
Let's how ready he's getting. Keep going.
Oh, my gosh.
I should be here more often.
No, I only hit about a third. Add a decorum to Kristen and Ally, we need to. Before we go down that road, big event for the Kidney Foundation, guys. It's next weekend. You can, and Justin, you actually did this, right? You can rappel down a building, right?
It's Rappel for Kidney Health. It's June 14th and 15th for the National Kidney Foundation. It's such a unique event. You can literally rappel down a 25-story building. We partner with a company called Over the Edge, and everything's safe, and it's for a great cause. A lot of money is donated and raised, and it's great.
Hey, Kristen, you were saying that a lot of fathers are being honored by their kids with a spot on in this thing here.
Yep, that's correct. So the event is on next weekend, which is also Father's Day weekend, which is a great way to connect with your dad and do it together. We have two ropes, so you can go down with your dad.
Ooh, cool.
Or you can do it in honor or memory of your father. We have a lot of folks who have lost a father or have a father who's fighting kidney disease. So really connecting and sharing their stories, and it's just a unique opportunity that weekend.
Have either one of you done it before, the actual rappel itself?
So we have not. It's the 10th year for the event.
We've done it in the past.
Was it awesome?
The hardest part
he got yelled at.
Is cresting the edge.
Right.
Okay.
Once you're there, you're good. What happened was I was swinging around on the rope and I smacked
Bofa these nuts.
Come on. Now here's what I did.
Come on.
I was told that the ropes are just rock solid. They're fine.
Yeah,
you're dealing with professional climbers.
You could hang a car off of that.
Yeah,
rope.
Exactly. You could hang a Nissan. You'd make it safely. Well, I do this bit where I put my feet on the wall and I pushed away and then like swung back and slammed into the wall.
Not knowing that you would come back, right?
Gotcha. Yeah.
You're just supposed to go straight down. Normally.
I push off and I twirl all the way around and smack into the wall. And I'm like, I'm banging into the wall. Thank God those harnesses held because I'm 9 stories up. I'm just a greasy splotch if it doesn't work. And I got myself a talking to for the ages.
Yeah.
One of the organizers was like, why don't you not do that?
Yeah.
You got a harness. I mean, you've got a harness, but the rope is up top of the building.
There's a whole professional rig up there.
It's rigged up there, tethered up there, and you kind of, you know, you do the rappel where you walk down the down the wall.
It's interesting. Almost out of your hands as far as the descent. There is a pro up top and a pro at the bottom. It's as safe as can be. I would do it again in a heartbeat before skydiving. Skydiving was the worst thing I've ever done. I would go down the side of a building again, dressed in tactical gear, looking like a badass, doing that thing where you swoop in through the window and you pull a
Tom Cruise.
You pull a gun on someone. Get down! I would love to do that.
Well, we still have spots available, so you can hold your spot on June 15th.
Where can people go if they want to find out more and get signed up and stuff?
Sure. They can go to kidneymd.org, which is our website, and you can click on there for rappel registration and we'll get you registered and get you fundraising and get you set up.
And pay attention to the instructors. Just don't jack around.
A lot of guys can jack it.
Don't mess around. But just,
you
just pay attention to what they do.
Your big fundraisers
exactly.
In the
so
fall,
we have
right?
We have a full calendar year of events coming up. We have our golf tournament in September, and then our big, huge event is a walk in October 6th. We're really excited to kind of break some records on attendance and fundraising goals, and it's going to be great.
Yeah, my dad and Ally's grandfather had kidney disease and received dialysis the whole process, and it was he got some great care, and it was an amazing journey.
Yeah, we do a lot with actually working with dialysis centers and giving back to patients who need some emergency assistance. So the money actually goes directly to patients, which is a pretty unique thing for nonprofit.
Yeah, Kristen, when you see that bond between a daughter and a father who's going through kidney disease or kidney dialysis, whatever, and they come out of it. What a great story.
It is. And we've heard stories, of folks who are on the dialysis, and then they're on the transplant wait list and then they finally get that transplant. So we actually have patients who have been medically cleared who can do the rappel event.
Oh, that's awesome.
So even if you are not able to rappel or you don't want to rappel, all of the fundraising dollars go to allow a patient to rappel. So for every dollar amount that we have for the rappel spots, we can offer that to a patient.
Oh, very cool. I think Josh, do you want to do it, right, Josh?
Donate my kidney?
No, you...
Both.
Rappel.
You could if you want.
I'm going to... Rappel your kidney. Do you see that table in the corner? You strap me down right now, slice me open, I'll give you my kidney.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Hey, Ally, give us the most dad thing that Keith has done. Maybe an embarrassing dad story. Like that he used to walk around the house in his boxers.
Oh, come on.
Something away from the...
I never did that.
Away from the glitz and the glam.
I never did that.
I want to hear dad Millsy stories.
I mean, he's funny, but he's the same person as Keith Mills and dad. I mean, it's not like a stage presence when he's Keith Mills. It's just, it's just my dad.
He used to walk around like farting or burping.
No. He was very modest.
You having some friends over?
Seven minutes listening to this for the next, whatever. But
messing with the old man, baby.
Anyways, we apologize.
No, you don't.
This is devolving.
What about, when Keith leaves, what about your daughter taking over?
Yeah, you want to take over for sports?
I have a lot of things going on with kidney, so I'll be pretty busy.
Yeah, are you a sports person?
I love sports.
You got to be, right?
I was born and raised in sports, and I had the gift of talking, apparently, but... I love the nonprofit world. I've been in there for 6 years
well,
now.
That's good because we don't pay well.
Great story. I'm coaching a baseball team at Cardinal Gibbons, and Ally is a student at Towson, and you're watching Towson's baseball team, and Drew Permison is pitching, right?
Yeah.
And we're playing a game, and she knew a lot of guys on our team. Our catcher, Andrew Parker, is one of her best friends. So I get a text during the game, Dad, how come Drew can't control his changeup?
Wow.
So I walk over to Andrew. I said, Andrew, Allie's at the game. Look at this. He's like,
I was raised. I was raised on baseball.
She's like a scout.
Oh, no, you said
sitting up in the stands.
Drew can't control his changeup. So as I call her, I said, is my buddy Dean Albany, scout for the Orioles. I said, is Mr. Dean there? Are you sitting next to Mr. Dean and you're hearing this? No, he can't control his changeup.
She said,
well, tell him not to throw it.
Wow.
And the guys were just killing the heir apparent. You need to take it.
Yeah, maybe one day. But, for right now, it's... you know.
Do you have the ability to weave a fine tale, tell a Millsy storytelling ability?
I was blessed with my dad's sense of
spin a yarn
personality.
Yes.
I don't mean to be sappy, but do you see the way they're looking at each other? Like, how much they love each other?
It's the best.
Don't have that kind of relationship.
Listen, I can only pray that when my daughter reaches this age, that she looks at me the way
I've never seen that before.
I know.
Stella's what, 5 now?
She's going to be 6. But listen, I got a lot of years to mess that up.
Nah, you're not going to mess that up because
you haven't done it. So.
Hey, listen, we've had our moments together. Throw our clothes out in the front lawn because we didn't clean our room.
That's badass.
Yeah.
Three strikes, you're out. Out they went.
Yeah, for a good 15 minutes.
She put them all in a bag. She put them all in a bag and left them in the bag.
Lasted a weekend, right?
Yeah. My father never looked at me like that.
My father never cared enough to throw all of my underwear.
I'm sorry, Kristen. We've dominated the conversation.
I was going to say that we're actually passing the mic to Ally at Rappel, so she'll be doing all the announcing.
I'm going to be emceeing it, like following in my dad's footsteps.
One of the best MCs in the city.
So we were at Twain's. The Kidney Foundation had a fundraiser a couple of weeks ago across the area. Our area was Twain's down in it used to be Bamboo Bernie's, just where we did that thing that night. And she gets on the mic, man. She slammed it. She
just her first co-hosting, and it was
first time we did it together.
It was kind of it was.
So
nice.
Her brother Nick works for a commercial real estate company in D.C. and he just they're starting their researchers to go on camera now and do their presentations on camera, send it out over the web and stuff. So he just did like a 17-minute on-camera presentation. So we went over some things about writing for TV and keeping it simple and stuff like that.
Keeping it concise. Bang it out. Did he bang it out?
He didn't bang it out.
He banged it out.
Just bang some of those dongers.
Banged it out. Because it could be hard.
Is it hard?
How many people were there?
I just kind of hunkered down there and watched 7-8 guys at one time, you know?
I mean, it can be hard to do what Keith does. I mean, especially when you're tight for time.
Your end is probably tighter than his.
But the guy tells you what's on his mind. He's raw.
Raw as they come.
Raw.
That meat is sensational.
A lot of guys can jack. Anytime you can go inside something, it's a pretty cool thing.
Oh, you're telling me.
This is the greatest morning of my life.
I have 1,000 of them.
It is. I mean, I love being here.
So we spent a little bit of time downstairs meeting, Jen Franciotti and Mindy Becerra, some of the classy people in the station.
Oh, shit.
Then we come up here in this animal house, and you got to embarrass yourself.
Yeah, he's not wrong.
Well, I appreciate
you guys letting us come on here and talk about this.
I got
a chance.
I got a chance to see what a functional family looks like.
Oh, God.
I'm so sad now.
Keith, we will put a link to the event on our Facebook page and our Twitter.
And we'll have them come back for the big walk, too, in the fall.
Yeah, I'll be back.
Yeah, I'll be down in Florida hanging out with all my other friends.
We'll do a reunion with Dad and I.
Look how much they love each other.
I know, they're holding hands. And like,
oh, come on now.
Come on.
The way she looks at you, I've never seen something like that.
She's got a 22-month-old now, right?
Yes. Oh. 22-month-old. Baby Ray.
How's baby Ray?
She's good.
There she is.
Baby
Ray.
We're all real happy for you. Yes. Everybody in here's got kids, but...
Yeah, I'm afraid of people.
Oh, don't worry, Josh. You can adopt.
Yeah. But Kristen, your son is how old?
He is 5. He'll be 6.
5, and he's a big baseball player, right?
He's been playing since 18 months.
18 months?
What? 18 months?
How do you even do that?
My kid's 3 and doesn't talk.
That's your price.
Keith, we'll do it all again tomorrow, 6:35.
Thank you guys so much.
Thank you.
Josh Spiegel has made an all-new horrible memory, now realizing that he'll never have the relationship that Keith does with his
daughter. Let's tap into that a
daughter.
Little bit.
Yeah, because we got a new, all-new horrible Spiegel childhood memory queued up.
Yeah.
God. They love each other.
Yeah, no, it's just...
Was that hard?
Yeah, I never really saw a father and daughter look at each other like that. You could see the love was palpable. It was really touching, actually.
Like they're friends, too.
Yeah, I was almost tearing up.
Because you see people that love each other, but they're not friends like that.
As that was going on, I kept looking over at you, and I couldn't... The wheels were spinning, but I couldn't tell what it was. I thought maybe you were enamored a little bit with the way she's just so effortless.
The way she was looking at him, he must be an amazing father.
He's an amazing man.
He is these days.
God, he's like a second father to me. You get all these people that when I yell and scream at him and they, Scott, you're an ass, whatever.
You put some respect on that man's name.
How dare you do?
And you could see how he was looking at her, how proud he is.
I have leaned on Keith so much, especially in the last year.
I had sex into that. With him.
But he's always there for me, and he's just, and I couldn't imagine that being my actual father. You know what I mean? Imagine if that's your flesh and blood. He's a legend. He's an Adonis. And then I have him as a father.
I want her to replace him in the sports.
I now have a new one seed pick, yes. And it is Keith's daughter, yes. Whose name I have already forgotten. I need
Ally.
That's the one. That's where Keith and I met. I need her to be. I need her to be the new sports. I need Ally Mills on sports. She's even got the crack in her forehead starting to show up. Management. She's everything we need. We need another. She's a great female voice around here. She knows her sports.
It's Josh Spiegel. Remember, there are lots of ways to listen to 98 Rock every day. 97.9 FM, streaming live on 98online.com. The 98 Rock smartphone app on iPhone and Android and on your Amazon Alexa and Google Home. Make sure to follow us on Facebook at facebook.com/98online.